Hey man, it's me, ZW. And the subject of today's customization is the one and only Tony Stank. After last week's tragedy, is it my proudest word? I think that it's really time for me to try hair rooting. This week, I'm going to try and redeem myself by attempting three customization techniques that I've not done before. First, as promised, hair rooting. Then I'll try to bulk up a silicone body and paint it. First, let's take a look at the head sculpt that I'm repainting today. I've already gone through the process in my Black Widow video, so let me highlight some things that I've done differently for these heads. This one in particular will be my test subject for my first ever hair rooting experiment, and I will be prepping it for rooting in a minute. It is a head from Elite Toys, and I'm not sure if it's a recast or not, but it's pretty good, so I'll try to fix it with a repaint. Now this second one, it is a recast of a very expensive head sculpt by YK Kim, an ex-Hot Toys sculptor. And the originals were painted by Yelim Painter, if I'm not wrong. Oh, she's so talented, and my repaint will be so far from that standard. But what I'm interested in is the sculpture itself, so I'm really looking forward to painting it. Let us get rid of the existing paint. Alright, this part is a little bit different, prepping it for hair rooting. The idea is to get rid of the existing sculpted hair so that we can make way for some real hair, not human hair. I'll be using Tibetan lamb fur as recommended by Jacob. I really prefer to just cut it off layer by layer as opposed to using a Dremel tool to grind it off because it's a lot cleaner and there won't be dust interfering with my painting later on. Now that that's done, let's start painting. While I was painting YK Kim's Tony Stark sculpture, all I could think about was how different it felt from my own 3D printed one. I mean, with the details and variation in the hair, I'm willing to bet that it's traditionally sculpted. And the way that he sculpted certain parts of the face is just so different from how I would have done it. But of course, I'm not a professional sculptor, so it really made me wonder how I could improve my own sculpting process. I guess that's a plus when painting somebody else's work. Now, it's time to finally try this. It actually took me some time to build up the courage to try hair rooting because I don't know, the uncertainty of trying something new and maybe failing is such an unpleasant feeling. The idea is to build up the hair layer by layer, starting from the bottom, and then move your way up to the top and to the front of the head. And I'm afraid the worst has come true. This is me following Jacob's tutorial and I'm struggling so much. Okay, it. I'm so sorry. I had to take my time and figure it out on my own because I'm really learning on the go. So this is the result of a very, very poor attempt. He looks like he has bald spots all over. I'll have to try again on another head, and I will film the whole process next time. Please stay tuned. And for this head, I want to dirty him up, make him a little sweaty, because I want him to be in a cave building the Mark 1. Now we can do some modifications to the body. I've already done some sloppy work on it. It's a Tia Odor dark-skinned version, painted a little too orangey to match the previous head sculpt skin tone. And only the top is painted because, you know, he's wearing something later on, so work smart, not work hard, right? Nah, I'm just lazy. But before I fix the paint on the body, the proportion of the body is bugging me. Why is there this unnatural gap in between his shoulders? It just looks wrong. So I'm gonna cut him up. Relax, it's just a hole. Just big enough to stuff some cotton balls in and bulk him up and cover those gaps. Again, he's gonna wear some clothes over it, so it's fine. Use something long like a chopstick to maneuver your way to the area that you want to increase in size, and repeat until you are happy with the result. For the painting portion, I found this method on this forum, which has a very extensive discussion about the various ways to paint a silicone body. And I'm using the pastel method because I feel that I have more control over the colors. Similar to painting a head, it takes multiple different layers of colors to make it realistic. Once it's been rubbed onto the body, it stays on pretty well. Now let's put on a singlet and see if I've missed any spot. Yep, looking good, especially the parts where I filled the gaps up, it looks more natural. And since I've dirtied up the head sculpt, I thought I should do the same to the body and the outfit. So what do you think? Did either of them turn out well? It's funny because I did most of the work on Cave Tony, but I still like the Nano Tony a lot better. I guess it's because the head sculpt is so fantastic, right? Such a shame that he had to leave Hot Toys. Whoever took over him has big shoes to fill. The outfits for this week are very straightforward. I used Super MC Toys Nano Suit for Nano Tony, and TYS Toys Cave Dioramas outfit for Cave Tony. Alright, thank you guys for watching this video. If you have enjoyed it, remember to
like, subscribe, turn on notification bell.
As per usual, stay to the end of the video for a hint on upcoming videos. Bye!
Epico. Language.